Okay, today we discuss the last topic, Laplace equation. Our plan is now at this session we discuss Laplace, and after that you have with online with two questions for why. In fact, I just repeat two questions from the end term why training. I saw that one student, Mr. Tiến Nam. Is Tiến Nam here? Oh, good. I think I see you spend time, you touch YouTube, a very good score for hit 100%. I am very content. And the score for Laplace, no, the score for y is still good. 5 out of 6, good. So today we will have the small quiz, two questions that I repeat. The y topic. After that, this afternoon, student, this evening, we continue Laplace exercises and the quiz for Laplace. And you know, Tuesday, you have the Laplace IOC and the mixture lab in the last quiz. And Thursday you have examination. One thing I want to highlight that student, I never like the kind of review. So using the online VK learning, I will create overall three quizzes, three online trainings, one for HIIT, one for Y, and one for Laplace, with two applications from the first half, understand? So, like Mr. Tiến Nam, you spend time for teach online, and I think you can believe that, okay, if you repeat, if you cannot get high score, but if you spend effort, you touch the good understanding of formula. So in the end term examination, you must repeat, you only repeat your skill, your habit. So what is the Laplace equation, student? The difference that we will not use the OXY coordinate. We will use the polar. For polar, student, one point M before described by a couple S, Y. Now we'll describe by a couple A, theta. A is radius, theta is the angle. So A on Y greater or equal zero. And theta generally from 0 to 2 pi. But we can touch the same theta from minus pi to pi. In this system, the Laplace equation is A square second derivative u displaced A plus A first derivative plus second derivative respect theta equal zero. And we will give you the Laplace equation inside one disk, student. The disk will be in that form. Understand? And you see the disk is closed domain with the boundary. This is the circle. In fact, several times we understand the disk like the circle. Okay, anyway, it's still a safe table understanding. But anyway, distinguish. If I say this, so you have domain inside. If we say circle, this is only boundary. So the circle student, this is A equal I. And when A equal I, your function will take some value given. So this is the kind of directly boundary condition. Understand? We have that. So we have that problem. Laplace equation inside this and the condition yield A theta equal that one. And now, pay attention. This is the difference between Hitwise and Laplace. This also the difference between the formula that you took from the book and the formula that I give you. After long discussion using C variable form, we can show, let's say, don't know student. U, A, theta, will be A0 plus 2 plus the sum A power N multiply AN cos N theta plus BN sin N theta. So what feature you can note here? First, it's still some understand like hit and y. Inside you have some kind of A multiplying some function of theta. And it's very similar to all the problem. But now this is the official formula that Benny Book give you. But now if you substitute condition A equal 3 boundary, you will have the problem A0 plus 2 plus the sum of AN cos N theta plus BN sin N theta. But don't forget multiplying outside this A. This A 3 power N. Understand? And that one equal that function. You can find, but because you multiplying 3 power N here, so you must divide later. So I think this note really convenient for us. So I modify that formula. Instead of A power N, I will write here A over A power N. A this is the radius. So when you substitute, for example, here A equal 3, so you have A over 3. And when you substitute A equal 3, this factor will be 1. So cancel. So you find directly A and B N. Understand? Myself, I consider it slightly better. So I always use this modified formula. So student, I like to highlight. And if you see your friend, okay, I will repeat one more time this evening. If you touch the formula from Penny Book, it's okay. But if you touch that formula myself, I consider this is an improvement. And now when you have that one, you can find A and B easily. Do you agree with me? So I think now we will write the official answer of that one. This is also the kind of answer that we wait for you we rewrite for you in the end term examination. So when you have that Laplace problem, when you have the disk, radius equal 3. So you immediately note solution this A, I0 plus 2 plus the sum here. I, because you are here, I like to mention that student, I never understand. There were students who renote that formula. And in the end term examination, when I change radius to, for example, students still use that formula. So, spend attention here. Number 3 here, this note for all problems. And boundary condition. We have the general Fourier problem. And so you get A0 to this A. So, sin here that means B. And N equal 2. So B to this A, 3. And A with index, they're student. A of which number? 5. Equal minus 7. And your full answer. This is A0 over 2 plus first and equal 2. So 3 multiply A square over 9 and equal 2 multiply it sin 2 theta. And next and equal 5. So minus 7. A power 5 over 3 power 5 multiply in cos 5 theta. Understand? And if I ask you to find U 1 over 5, so this is A, this A theta. So this is the first version. There you touch full answer without Fourier integral. Student, now we will touch Fourier integral. We will have three cases. Spend attention. The most general, you must find both A and B n. Two special cases, when you find only AN, that means B equals 0, and only BN, A equals 0, understand? So what is this? Oh, here, the equation, Laplace equation is hidden, but I think you remember. The most important that radius and initial condition. When you note radius, immediately you can write the full formula, understand? Okay. Next student, when you substitute r equal i, you will have the full Fourier problem over minus pi to pi. So as we already mentioned, an will be
1 over by bn will be 1 over by integral. One thing to note that here, n greater or equal 0, but bn n greater or equal 1. If you take n equal 0, you don't have cos there. But still done, we have two special cases. First, if your initial function is even, that means f minus theta equal f theta. Which kind of function even student? To recognize student, some function like absolute size, understand, or the even power. Remember, you have two kind of answer, code and sense. And high school, we already studied code A even and sin A odd because you have cos minus theta equal cos theta. But sin minus theta equal minus sin theta. So if you see the initial function A odd A even, so inside your answer you have only even, so you have only cos to be zero. Understand? When you have in odd, excuse me, even f, so inside your answer you have only cos. And instead of integral minus pi to pi, you can reduce into only zero pi. Because minus pi to pi is twice of 0 pi. So outside here you have 2 over pi. Do you understand? It looks like integral minus pi to pi equal 2 times of 0 pi. Similarly, when you have f theta is odd, that means inside f theta you have only odd power. Understand? So if you have that, your answer is only sin. And similarly, instead of integral minus pi to pi, you have 0 pi. Student, that example you just see, because now I must leave you with the wish for why. So this afternoon, this evening, we will together understand, do some numerical example for Laplace, but this is the way to write the answer here. First, can you tell us the official formula? Note the radius here, 2. So your formula will be, let's read, I0 over 2, don't forget that, plus the sum inside what we have, student, A over 2 Rayleigh power n. Multiplying in cos n theta plus bn sin n theta. Now, we take A equal to boundary condition. So, substituting, you have that sum. Equal theta. But here you see theta there like theta power 1. 1 this is odd number. So your right hand side is
odd function. So inside your solution, you must have only odd. That means you have only sin, rightly. So you immediately you note an equals 0. Understand? Bn will be 2 over pi. That function similarly, if now I change student, if instead of theta, I take for example three absolute size of theta. So because we have the same radius, so you have the same function, the same solution. But the initial condition now is understand, and that function now we this is even. So you have inside your answer, you must have only even. That means you have only cos. So bn equals 0. Understand? And you can write slightly longer but clearer. A zero first. Some of you can worry about absolute size. Don't worry, because you have 2 over pi integral 0 to pi of that function. But when theta greater or equal 0, the absolute size theta is theta. So you don't have absolute size. And an similarly 3 theta cos and theta. And the last detail still done. Now, what happens if we ask you to approximate that solution by sum of two first term? So here still done. In the general case, you see the sum is decided by n. And that term like n equals 0. So sum of two first term in general case, you must start n equals 0. That means a 0. And n equals 1. This is both a 1, b 1. Student, don't you cannot distinguish an and bn. The term there is numerated by only n. So n equal 1, even you have both a1 and b1, but we consider the sum like first term. Do you understand? So if we have general case, if we ask you the sum of two first term, you must start a0, a1, b1. That means three number. But for the case odd, if we ask sum of two first term, so what you must start? So that one, you don't have cos, understand? You have only sin. And this term, this series, become by 1. So sum of two first term will be b1, b2. But for this case, student, when you have even, sin will cancel. So you have only cos, and you say that sum start from n equal 0. So the sum of two first term now, this is a0, a1. Do you understand? The same question, but under their context, you take different an and bn. Okay, that's all for this morning. B.
two first term, this will be a student. In this case, when you have odd, so an equals zero. Do you understand? So you have only sin and the sum of sin. A zero and one, no, that is zero already. Surely, because I repeat that when you have odd case, the right hand side odd, so the left hand side will have only sin, and the sum of sin start from n equal 1. So when we say 2 first term from 1, so you take n equal 1 and equal 2. But when you have only cos, so the sum start from 0. Do you see? So you take a0, a1. But the most general case, when you have 2 first term n equal 0, this term be easy. But the next term when n equal 1, you have both inside. And you must take on. I think you understand. We cannot say that teacher cos before sin. No, no, no. Cos and sin, they are equal. Understand? In the meaning. And don't worry, this evening, when we take numerical example, we touch on that. That means at least I must give you general and odd and even and on trade for sum of two first terms. So you will one more time to be checked whether you understand this notion or not. And the last thing, the password for today, this is Monday. So now please go to BKL. That's the wish.